So in cycle 13, what happens is this ROB2 instruction finally writes its result. This result is 12. We mark now this instruction as done. And the value of 12 will be broadcast under the name of ROB2. So now these instructions here are waiting for their inputs. And this one here matches that, you know, I'm waiting for ROB2 value. So it captures it here. This is the first operand that we're waiting for. The second operand was already there since a while ago. So this instruction, which is the ROB4 instruction, is no longer waiting for anything. It can actually dispatch in this cycle 13, and in cycle 14, the fourth instruction begins executing. None of the other instructions are waiting for ROB2. So this concludes what happens when we broadcast the value in cycle 13 for the ROB2 instruction. What now happens is, again, in cycle 14, we begin executing this multiplication. And because it has begun executing in this cycle, this reservation station is already free. It was freed when we dispatched in the previous cycle. So I'm going to note that this multiplication of 12 and 13, which gives us 36, is going to end up in ROB4 eventually here. But it's not going to be done until 10 cycles from cycle 14. So it's going to be in cycle 24 that we try to write the result. These two instructions still are waiting for ROB4 and ROB5 instructions, and this happens beyond cycle 14. So in cycles 15, 16, etc., nothing really happens. In fact, nothing will happen until we have another broadcast of a result, and the results we will broadcast eventually are going to be in 42 and 24. 24 comes first, so let's see what happens in cycle 24. In cycle 24, the fourth instruction will broadcast the result. This is the multiplication here. So what's going to happen is the value of 36 is going to be broadcast under the name of ROB4. This instruction is waiting for ROB4, so it's going to capture the value of 36 and mark that we are no longer waiting for this operand. This instruction actually now doesn't wait for anything anymore. So in cycle 25, the subtract is going to start executing. Meanwhile, our ROB4 instruction gets marked as done. Basically, this value of 36 that was broadcast also gets kind of deposited here and marked as done in the ROB. And this kind of concludes what happens with this multiplication instruction as far as pre-commit stuff is concerned. It cannot commit yet again because we need all of these to commit before it can commit. So it's still going to be at least cycle 43 before we consider committing anything. In this cycle 24, however, the ROB5 instruction will be dispatched. And it will begin again executing in cycle 25. So let's just move to cycle 25.